Hi, my name is Motoko Yanagita. I'm the professor and chair of the Department of Nephrology in Kyoto University Graduate School of Medicine. I'm also the PI of ASHBI in Kyoto University. My team has been mainly working on the mechanism of kidney disease progression. Before we share some data, I'd like to provide some background. Acute kidney injury, AKI in short, is a very common clinical condition characterized by a rapid decline of kidney function, often as a result of an ischemic or toxic insult. Recently, it is widely recognized that a significant proportion of AKI survivors progress to chronic kidney disease or end-stage renal diseases. The prognosis of AKI in the elderly is particularly poor and often progresses to CKD and ESRD. However, the reason for this and pathophysiology of AKI in the elderly remains unclear. Previously, we have shown that aged kidney, but not young kidneys, exhibit tertiary lymphoid tissue after AKI, which underlie maladaptive repair. Tertiary lymphoid tissue is an inducible ectopic lymphoid tissue and generates adaptive immune responses to locally presented antigens. We also found that CD4 positive T cell depletion in kidney disease model halted TLD development with improved fibrosis and inflammation. However, the cells and molecular pathway that govern TLD formation are poorly defined.
Hi, my name is Yuki Sato. I'm an assistant professor of Department of Nephrology, Graduate School of Medicine, Kyoto University. The aim of this study is to define key immune cell and molecule responsible for TLD formation in aged injured kidney. Firstly, by single-cell RNA-seq analysis and flow cytometry, we found the accumulation of two unique age-dependent lymphocytes, senescence-associated T cell, SAT cells, and age-associated B cell, ABC, in aged-injured kidney with TLT. SAT cells are CD4 T cell subpopulation characterized by cell surface expression of PD-1 and TNF superfamily member molecule CD153. Additionally, such cells produce ABC-inducing factors such as the IL-21 and interferon gamma. ABC are B cell characterized by cell surface expression of CD11B and CD95. We also found that ABC express CD30, the receptor of CD153. Interestingly, such cell and ABC appear simultaneously with TLT formation. By in-situ hybridization and reporter mouse analysis, we also found that SAT cell and ABC are located almost exclusively within TLTs and found very close to each other. This spatiotemporally synchronized development of SAT cell and ABC within TLT suggests that the development of these two unique age-dependent lymphocytes is mechanistically linked. So to identify the interaction molecule between SAT cell and ABC, we performed unbiased ligand receptor analysis and you identified CD153, CD30 as a signaling pathway between SAT cell and ABC. Next, we explore the role of CD153, CD30 signal in TLT formation using CD153 and CD30 knockout mice. As you can see here, genetic deficiency of CD153 result in defective TLT formation and reduced ABC numbers. Similar results were obtained using CD30 knockout mice. We also investigate the gene expression profile of SAT cell and ABC in the absence of CD153 and CD30. SAT cell loss gene expression of genes related to B cell helper function and other SAT cell specific genes in the absence of CD153 and CD30. In contrast, the expression levels of ABC identity genes are not changed. So these results indicate that the CD153 CD30 signal control SAT cell but not ABC identity genes. To evaluate the impact of targeting this signal on renal function, we induced adenine nephropathy to CD153 knockout mice and found they exhibited defective TLT formation with improved renal function and fibrosis. Therefore, targeting CD153, CD30 signal might be effective for preventing kidney disease progression. Importantly, we also confirmed that human TPH, TFH, and ABC in patients with rheumatoid arthritis also express CD153 and CD30 respectively.
Finally, I'd like to summarize our findings in this paper. We found that two age-dependent lymphocytes, SAT cells and ABCs, accumulate within TLTs in the kidney after injury, where they interact via CD153 and CD30. This interaction is required for SAT cell to acquire ABC-inducing ability and is essential for TLT formation. We additionally determined the therapeutic potential of CD153-CD30 signaling in kidney disease progression. Our findings might guide the development of a novel therapeutic strategy for kidney diseases in the elderly.